Hi, I'm Evan Zhang, and welcome to Back to Basics. Today, we're going to talk about hosting static websites on AWS. Before the cloud, hosting a website often meant setting up a web server and serving content out of a network connected storage. This was the case even if you just wanted to serve static assets such as CSS, HTML, and JavaScript files. Not only did you have to provision a server, but you also had to patch the server, scale resources to meet demand, managing a complex deployment process, and making sure all the SSL certificates were renewed and valid. What if I told you you don't have to do any of that today? Simply leverage some AWS services, you can have a highly performant and scalable way of hosting a static website, all without having to manage a single server. Let's dive into the most common architecture pattern to do this with. To start, you can store all your web assets, such as your CSS, HTML, and JavaScript files on Amazon Simple Storage Service, or otherwise known as S3. By storing your web assets on Amazon S3, you have immediate access to 4 nines of availability and 11 nines of durability. S3 will also scale automatically to help you to meet the fluctuating demands of requests. And since there are no servers, you won't have to worry about patching or scaling anything. Although you can configure S3 to host a static website using its out-of-box functionality, it does come with 2 limitations. 1. You must grant public read access to the S3 bucket that is hosting your website, which may be challenging in situations where you have blocked public access to all of your S3 buckets. 2. S3's out-of-box hosting does not support HTTPS for custom domains. So instead, it is best to use Amazon CloudFront, a cloud CDN service that will allow you to serve content out of S3 without having to enable any public access. By fronting your S3 bucket with a CloudFront distribution, you will also be able to distribute your website to over 225 points of presence globally, so that your users can access your website with ultra-low latency. Furthermore, through CloudFront, you also have access to CloudFront Functions, a lightweight serverless compute option that runs at edge locations for CDN customizations. For example, you can append HTTP headers to your responses, such as content security policies, to enhance the security posture of your website. Or you can route different user sessions to different builds of your website for A/B testing. Once you have the storage and the CDN sorted, the next thing you will need is a custom domain name and an SSL certificate to go with it. You can create a custom domain name through Amazon Route 53, a cloud DNS service, and an SSL certificate through Amazon Certificate Manager, or ACM. Both of these services integrate seamlessly with CloudFront, making it extremely simple to map a custom domain to a CloudFront distribution. To make it even easier, you no longer have to worry about renewing your SSL certificates anymore, because when used with CloudFront, ACM will do all the hard work and automatically renew your SSL certificates for you. And with just these few components, you already have a functional website. But we mustn't forget about the deployment process. With access to S3's rich APIs, the deployment process is also simplified. The best way to securely upload your web assets is using the S3 sync command of the AWS CLI, which will upload any new and updated files to S3. One thing to keep in mind though, if you're deploying a single page application, such as a React application, make sure that you upload this index.html file last after syncing all the other assets. This can be easily done by excluding the index.html file initially, and then running a subsequent sync command, including the index.html file. That way your users won't be loading a broken website during mid-deployment. Your whole deployment process can be as simple as 2 CLI commands, and this can be easily incorporated into your CI/CD pipeline. Lastly, observability is key to running any software applications, and a static website is no exception. CloudFront publishes a number of operational metrics to CloudWatch, such as the rate of 500 errors and the total number of requests received. Using these metrics, you can create a CloudWatch alarm to alert yourself when something has gone wrong. For example, alerting you when there's an unusually high number of 500 errors. But what if you just want some simple insights into your CloudFront activity? Well, you're in luck, because CloudFront also publishes a variety of reports, such as top referral reports and top objects reports. Using these reports, you can gain some insights into how users are interacting with your website without the need to install or manage any extra software. To conclude, using S3, CloudFront, Route 53, and ACM, we allow you to host a highly performant and scalable static website on AWS while removing the need to manage any servers. You can also leverage the additional functionalities to improve your security and observability posture, or even run A/B tests. This architecture pattern has been a game changer for many of my customers, and I hope it will be for you as well. Click the links in the description below for more details, and see you next time.